Hi, good day. This is welcome you to the YouTube session for the NEBOSH Diploma in Occupational Safety and Health. I want to welcome all those who are new to the channel, and just so you all know that we have had this channel before, and I get off COVID-19. We were trying to use it as a means of keeping you up to date with the weekly sessions. Just some guidelines here. You know, homework assignments will still be given for those who want to do your quiz. You can still do those and email them. If you should, perhaps leave a comment, something simple as, for example, your name and just a statement, perhaps saying that you were here. That will give us an idea of events for this. Again, just some main points here. This is actually my third attempt at this video, and there seemed to be a bit of software issue with this app that we are using here. So just in case you know, you see a blip or sound issue, I'm not quite really even have time to edit the video, or if I even want to spend time editing the video, I just upload it as a raw video. It's really not meant for public consumption, just for school. So to those who were there last session, we would have seen your textbook. So those of us with the book, or perhaps the syllabus, you could perhaps get now as we move into the session. So we would have reviewed chapter 3 a bit. Asbestos would have been the last thing that we completed. Today's session though would have more or less been on the LEV system. So let's go straight into that, the LEV system. Again, this here though, this would have been, we actually did cover this last week, Saturday. This is schedule 2 of the COSH regulations, 2006. Do a look at it. The idea behind this is that in terms of suggesting a control, that you do not simply suggest PPE as the first form of control, that is, PPE is not first, but you seek a higher order of control. And of course, those higher orders would be more along the lines of eliminate. So you see here, part A of schedule 2, design and operate processes and activities to minimize emission release. And I think D is of importance, because D is perhaps where the LEV system falls into. Choose the most effective and reliable control options which minimizes the escape and spread of substances hazardous to health. So I think just in terms of a passive question, if you were asked, how do you minimize the spread or the, you know, the escape of a substance hazardous to health, that you do not simply go to the LEV first, because the LEV is not first. And of course, as you know, PPE and information and whatever have you, training instructions would have not been first. So the idea though, even if today's session is on the LEV system, it's not the first order of control. It does fall, as most of you already know, under engineering controls, right? So this is just an idea here of how those controls could go. Substitution, of course, you know, this is the idea of how do you control a contaminant at the source, the air part, and the receiver. And perhaps the LEV does fall within the idea of the air pathway as opposed to the source, and PPE would be more relevant to the person. Here you see things here like general exhaust ventilation, dilute ventilation, which does suggest a bit of LEVs along the pathway, but not really solving the problem at the source, but on its way, you know, to the receiver. So just so you have not had any idea of what an LEV system look like, you would need to know the basic parts of the LEV system. And here you would have another, this is the best diagram anyway, either. I think the one before may have actually been a better one, but here you would have the basic parts, if I guess not pointed out to you all. I'm trying to see if I have a better diagram here, right? So this would have been a better one here, if you have never seen an LEV system before, right? So you'd have the, you'll have the collection hood, and just above your process you'll have the docking material. This could lead into a boot. Again, all of these are different types of hoods anyway, you'll do that in a bit. you'll have an air filter here, and that will be more or less run by a fan, and then this would be exhausted to the outside atmosphere. That's actually putting it very, very mildly, but it's just the basic idea is that there is a